Amen. Good to see you. Hey, buddy boy, how you doing? You even shaved for the new year. You and me both. It might be a while, right? We did it today. Get off our back, right? Come on. Good to see you guys. Let's jump up on our feet. Come on, let's have church. That's what we're doing. Amen. If it's your first time, I've met a few of you already today. Your first time at Fellowship. I'm Pastor Gary. You get to be you here. How you doing, family? How y'all doing? Are y'all alive? Right here. You see how mama ain't looking at me. Now, how y'all doing? Come on in the house. Come on in the house. Let's have church. Hey, buddy boy, how you doing, man? Good to see you, Chiefster. God bless you, man. But anyway, I'm Pastor Gary. You get to be you here today. You didn't turn the lights off on us. We can't even see how to get to our seat. What's wrong with you? Come on. No, appreciate it. Y'all doing pretty good? Yes or no? Pretty good? Good. Good. Come on. If you're new, I'm going to go ahead and break the news to you. You're going to love me. No, it might take a while, but you'll get there. I'm a little slow. But I'm glad you're here today. And got Mitchell's away today. But I tell you what, we got Joel stepping up to the plate today and the whole gang up here. We appreciate y'all. Got a great song starting out. Yeah, come on. Appreciate you. Looking forward to it. Amen. You're watching online. Thank you. Why don't you go ahead and send us a note right now? You're watching online. Just an encouraging word. We're glad to have you and just encourage one another out there online this morning. But I hope you had a great Christmas. We did. Amen. And had some incredible football yesterday. I know if you're Ohio, that was rough, man. That was rough. I mean, start your new year. I mean, literally, it started your new year. At 12 o'clock last night. But what a good game. Y'all tried. Amen. Come on. What are you going to do? 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 Amen. But Happy New Year. Let's say that together on the count of three. One, two, three. Happy New Year. Amen. And let's thank God we live in America. Let's come on. Come on. Don't give up. Don't give up on your country. Here we go. The song, I heard it for the first time when y'all did it. It was called Graves into Gardens. God can turn a grave into a garden. He can make beautiful out of some tough situations. Amen?
That's right.
Let's tell saltwater we love them today. Let's just be encouraging. Let's start off like that. Amen? Come on. Here we go. Thank you. Welcome today.
The world, but it couldn't fill me. Man's empty praise and treasures that fade are never enough. Then you came along, then you put me back together. Now every desire is now satisfied here in your love. Oh, there's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing, nothing is better. I'm not afraid to show you my weakness, my failures and flaws. Lord, you see them all, and you still call me friend.
Amen. Come on, church.
'Cause the God of the mountain, still the God of the valley, and there's not a place your mercy and grace won't find me again. Oh, there's nothing better than you, better. Oh, there's nothing better than you. Oh, there's nothing better than you. Oh, there's nothing, nothing is better than you. You turn mourning to dancing. You give beauty for ashes. You turn shame into glory. You're the only one who can. You turn mourning to dancing. Give beauty for ashes. You turn shame into glory. You're the only one who can. You turn graves into gardens. You turn bones into armies. Turn seas into highways. You're the only one who can. You're the only one who can. Oh, there's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing that's better. Nothing is better than you.
Amen. I love that. I could keep singing that. Amen. Praise the Lord, man. What you got coming up next, Joel?
Got a Psalm 8.
A psalm. Well, yep. You did, back a year or two ago, y'all took us through a lot of psalms. That's probably one of them, isn't it?
Yep, I think we've done this a couple times.
Amen. Here we go. Going to sing something right out of the book of Psalms. Are you alive? You okay? Come on, here you go. You're singing something right out of the Bible. Psalm chapter number 8. Let's learn it. If you don't know, we'll learn it together. Come on. Amen. Appreciate you.
Oh, Lord, our Lord. Oh, how awesome are your ways. And how majestic is your name in all the earth. Oh, Lord, our Lord. May we see your kingdom come. Father, may your will be done in all the earth. When I look at your heavens, moon and stars you set in motion, oh God. I sing all glory and honor. What is man that you are mindful, the Son of Man, that you would care for him? We sing all glory and honor, oh Lord, our Lord. Oh, how awesome are your ways. How majestic is your name in all the earth. Oh, Lord, our Lord. May we see your kingdom come. Father, may your will be done in all the earth. In all the earth gave dominion to your children, and you crown them, oh God, with glory and honor. So sing of your name. We live our lives for your greatness, oh God. Your glory and honor, oh Lord. majestic is your name in all the earth. Oh Lord, our Lord, may we see your kingdom come. Father, may your will be done in all the earth. The earth is full of the glory of God. Come make much of the name above all names. Creation cries out in every knee bows. Jesus, we crown you, O Lord, our Lord. The earth is full of the glory of God. Come make much of the name above all names. Creation cries out and every knee bows. Jesus, we crown you, O Lord, our Lord, O Lord, our Lord, O Lord, our Lord, O Lord. Oh, how awesome are your ways, how majestic is your name in all the earth. Oh Lord, our Lord, may we see your kingdom come. Father, may your will be done in all the earth. Oh Lord, our Lord, oh how awesome are your ways, how majestic is your name in all the earth. O Lord, our Lord, may we see your kingdom come. Father, may your will be done in all the earth.
Amen. That's what it feels like to sing Psalm 8. It's a great psalm. Man, a lot of that just keeps coming back when I sing in that, amen? That you're mindful of us. How great you are, God, amen? That you would love us. How many of you know you're a sinner, say? Come on, you know you've been screwed up a little bit. How about that? And God loves a snot out of you, amen? He gave his son for you. You might wonder why. Well, he created you in his likeness, in his image. And created Adam to fellowship with. Because of sin, sin came into the world and broke that fellowship because God's holy. But God is love. Say that out loud. God is love. God is love. And he gave his son. The Bible says he so loved the world. That's you. That's me. That he gave his only begotten son. That whosoever believes in him should not what? Perish but have everlasting life. You are loved here today. It's the first day of a new year. I've got a new series. That's funny. I wrote it 15 years ago. 15 years ago. And I actually recorded, and so I listened to it. I'm like, wow, I was a lunatic. Sort of still am. No, but no, it's a series on living in the now. Today is the only day you have. And we presume upon tomorrow, but the Bible says when we do that, that's evil. You don't know what you have on tomorrow. How many last year brought something in your life and you weren't expecting it? Let me see some hands. Look at that. Look at that. And most everybody, yeah. I'm just saying we don't know what a tomorrow is going to bring. You never get a tomorrow. You get tomorrow, it's today. Got it? Say. And so we've got a series going to encourage you today. It might be a little, might kick rear a little bit with this one. We'll see how we do. It'll be a strong series. But living in the now, we need that. Yes or no, amen. Come on. 2023. It's hard to believe, ain't it? 2023. I don't even know how to say it. You know what I mean? But anyway, we made it. Amen. Let's live for the Lord. Amen. Come on. Glad you're here. Let's pray together. Lord, thank you for loving us like you do. Lord, thank you for letting us gather here today. Lord, I'm grateful for all these folks. Lord, we don't want to have church without you, Lord. Be in our midst, we pray. Lord, I pray you'll use me today and use the others here, all of us. But I especially pray, Lord, you'll use me in some way to get across to folks today. If they don't know you as their Savior and their Lord, if they were to die, they don't know they'd go to heaven. Lord, I want to be part of seeing them come to you today. Lord, would you use us today? May they know their love today, that they matter, they have value. We've been taught so much craziness and our heads nuts. So Lord, I pray you'll help us. Can we see the simplicity today that Jesus, you love us, you came and died on a cross and rose from the grave so we could have everlasting life. Lord, would you save us today, those that need you today? Would you do it, Lord, today? We don't want any to leave lost here, not a one. Help us, we pray. Help us have a great church service. We want to honor you. We want to learn. We want to be encouraged. That's our prayer, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Be seated if you would. Amen. Mr. Alexander Christie. Buddy, we're going to be getting back to normal, ain't we?
Yes, sir.
Been a little bit crazy.
Good crazy.
It's though. Been a good crazy. Amen.
Yes, sir.
Go get them.
Thank you, sir. Good morning. Happy New Year, everybody. How are you today? Glad you're here. Thank you so much for being here this morning. We love and appreciate you. We know you could be anywhere this morning, starting your new year off anywhere, but you chose Fellowship Church, and we're grateful for that. And if today's your first time here, do us a favor, please, and fill out that guest registry that was on your worship. Well, you didn't get a worship guide this morning, as a matter of fact. You're getting calendars today, so forgive me. But if you're here for the first time today, what you could do instead is meet us out at the Welcome Center. And at that Welcome Center, they'll actually give you a little gift bag for coming over and just giving us a little bit of basic info. We promise not to bother you. We promise not to share that info. We're just going to send you a note of appreciation for you being here today, as well as a postcard whenever a big event is coming up. Like last year, I think we sent one postcard out, and that was for Christmas Eve concerts. Yeah, I don't think we did a ton of mailing last year, so we don't bother you much. But we just would love to stay in touch with you, and thank you for being here this morning. We have got communion right after church today, so before you head on over to hospitality, please take a moment, head out to the crosses, and take part in communion on this first day of the year with us. And we have, starting on the 6th, but next week we're going to start having sign-ups for Bible studies. So put it in the back of your mind, if you want to plug into a Bible study, starting the new year off correctly right here at the church, plugging into a Bible study with fellow believers, learning more, iron sharpens iron. We really love for people to get together and be able to talk about Scripture and get into God's Word together and learn more than just on Sunday. Grow throughout the course of the week in your own personal time as well as with others. Sign up next Sunday, right after the service or right before the service. They'll probably be out there already signing folks up. We are so excited about having a couple of Bible studies starting on Monday, a women's Bible study and a men's Bible study Monday evenings. And then we're going to have a Bible study on Wednesday mornings as well. So it's going to be just a really, really awesome chance. Lots of different opportunities for you to plug into a great study here at Fellowship Church. And come in this Wednesday, if anyone who can help us, we would really appreciate it. It won't take too long. At 8 o'clock, we're going to be here Wednesday morning before we start cleaning this place for the week. We want to break down the Christmas decorations. So if you have 20-30 minutes of time, we really would appreciate you coming on out. These trees, they all, they're like three pieces, and they all fit into a box. And the big one out there is all like the old-fashioned one. It's such a pretty tree, we keep putting it up every year. But we need your help, if you don't mind, coming on out next Wednesday, this Wednesday, I should say, at 8 a.m. to help us take down Christmas decorations.
Wait. How many can do that? Come on. There you go.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you. And this is that Wednesday morning Bible study I was talking about, study of Genesis. Miss Joanne's going to be leading this, and she'll be having signups next week. And Grief Share continues to meet every single Wednesday right here at Fellowship Church. If you or anyone you know is going through the grieving process, going through the process of loss, we really, really encourage you to come on out to this incredible group of folks that will come alongside you, that have suffered in the same way you have. They understand where you are. They understand how you feel, even though it's a different circumstance. We can come together and support each other and lift each other up. And that's what this organization, this group of people all want to do. So if you or anyone you know is going through that process, please come on out on a Wednesday, 4:30. It's an incredible group of people. And we can't encourage you enough to stay afterwards for Celebrate Recovery, Fellowship Recovery time. At 6 o'clock, they do a great meal out there in the foyer. And then they come in here at 6:30 for some incredible music, followed up by testimony time before they break into small groups. And they're all about helping you with your hurts, your hangups, any struggles you might be having. They want to come alongside you and get your walk with the Lord as close as possible. So come on out on a Wednesday for an awesome night of service. And next Saturday, gentlemen, we have a men's prayer breakfast. We're going to have a full breakfast. I talked to the folks that do that with us, and it's going to be an awesome, awesome breakfast next Saturday. There's no cost. It's 8 a.m. We'll have you out of here by 9, and we just would love for you guys to come on out. We're going to be meeting over by the picnic tables. And this is our town. Thank you so much for supporting Fellowship Church by wearing the shirts, putting the bumper stickers on your cars. It means a lot. We got so many people coming down. Vacationers are starting to come down. Snowbirds are going to be coming down soon. And we need your help getting them here so they can hear the gospel of Christ from Pastor Gary. So come on out. Go on out into the community, wearing those shirts, putting the bumper stickers on your cars, and helping us get the word out, please. And we always thank you so much for giving at Fellowship Church. We are a debt-free ministry because of you. Give2fc.com, super easy way to give online. Many of you have set up a weekly or a monthly gift. You can do a one-time gift through that, as well as that P.O. Box. We thank you for your notes of encouragement, everyone up north. And by the way, thank you for tuning in if you're watching live this morning. I forgot to say that this morning. Thank you for tuning in, and thank you for your notes. Thank you for your words of encouragement, filling that P.O. Box with love here at Fellowship Church. And right after communion, please come on back inside for some awesome hospitality. Make a new fellowship friend today. We'd love to get in touch with you. Thank you so much.
Amen. Appreciate
it. You did.
I didn't, but you know, blowing everything up next door.
Oh, yeah. I asked Alex if he stayed up late last night. He said no, but people were blowing everything up next door, you know. That's how we are. I think y'all know I'm a tightwad, right? Y'all know that about me? A little bit. I've got that reputation. I don't know why it is. It's crazy. Maybe it's because the shoes I have, somebody gave them to me. I didn't buy these. Are you kidding me? But no, for years I've said, we ain't buying fireworks. We'll go watch your neighbors. And there were just tons of them. It was crazy yesterday. I heard a lot of stuff. And I'm like, I'm glad. That's like $30 I didn't spend right there on that one. Anyway, how many stayed up last night all the way to midnight? Amen. There you go. How many stayed up because you were watching a football game? That's why you were up. I tell you what, that thing happened right at midnight. That was crazy the way it all wrapped up. OTCU won. That's crazy. Amen. Never would have expected that. In case you're like, I can't believe you're a pastor and talk about football. Get over it. You'll be fine. Okay, I am a man. I actually like that. And women too sometimes like it. Amen. Come on. Here we go. What's the song? Is it the original Above All? Yeah.
It's actually both songs into one.
Amen. But it's the original Above All. It's in here. Amen. It's one of the first contemporary Christian songs that was written back in the day, because I've been around a while. And but this is cool. So we appreciate you. Amen. Y'all just doing this, and we're just going to sit here and enjoy. We're standing up.
The last two songs, we're going to combine them.
Yeah.
Above All and Breathe.
Okay.
So whatever.
Yeah, well, let's get up. Come on, we're up. Let's go. Come on. Get on, stand on up. I'm not going to take any mercy on you.
We need the extra help today.
Come on, let's sing. Here we go. Come on. Get some blood flowing. Here we go. Above all. Amen. Appreciate it.
Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of men, you were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders this world has ever known, above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there no way to measure what you were. Crucified, laid behind a stone, you live to die, rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the fall and you thought of me. And all the ways of men, you were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders this world has ever known. Of all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you're worth. You were crucified, laid behind a stone. Rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the fall and you thought of me above.
I'm desperate for you.
This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my daily bread. My daily bread, your every word spoken to me. Yeah, I'm desperate for you. For you.
Love that song, man. Thank you, Joel, Sherry, the band. Thank you, guys. We love you. Thank you for leading us in worship today. Well, thank you for giving to the ministry here at Fellowship Church. We're a debt-free ministry, and I hope that continues to get on your nerves. I love being a debt-free ministry and giving God all the credit. Amen. And that's the credit we have here at Fellowship. That, yeah, God gets all the credit. Amen. But thank you for giving. And 2022 was probably our biggest year of giving ever in the ministry. Can we thank the Lord for that? Thank you, Lord. That was your blessing. Crazy. You'd say, that can't be. We had a hurricane. Well, just in regard to the hurricane, ever since we started raising funds, which would have been early second week or so of October probably, over $405,000 has been given. Amen. Come on. I'm going to tell you right now, and we've had a couple of checks come in even this week that's not in that figure, but we're going to knock the tar out of that. Amen, say. And but thank you for giving. And when the hurricane first happened, people said, well, you got $800,000 over there in that kid's wing. You can take that and fix things. And you know what? That's just not the way we do things here. And if we had to, we know that if a crisis hits. But you know what? It just showed that you can count on the Lord to bless through his people. And you are the people that were also hurt and God raised up. I got a check this week. Not a ton of them, but check this week from a church in Illinois. And I was at dinner one night and the pastor called me. I'm like, man, interrupted my dinner. I'm at a restaurant. And but I talked to him a little bit and told him I'd be happy to speak by phone or video or whatever. If they have any questions of us, I'll tell them. But about a $5,000 check from a church that I don't even know. I don't even know these people. Amen. I mean, it's crazy. But God's good. Amen. Praise the Lord. So I just want to encourage your heart. Amen. Today's offering goes to meet the needs of our ministry here. So if you can give cheerfully, we'll receive your gift. If for some reason you can't give it that way, we ask you to hang on to it. But when we give cheerful, there's plenty. You know what I mean? Say. Come on. So we don't want to guilt you into giving. I think if you look how good God's been to you, while I look at how he's been good to me, it's no problem to share. Amen. God's good to us. Amen. Coach, come on. Pray for us, buddy. I know that was a tough, tough loss last night. Big Ohio State. We're not saying a small Ohio State fan. And Roger the Dodger Johnson, he loves the Lord more than football, but that man loves Ohio State. I'm going to tell you that right now. But anyway, you can't help but be proud of your team, though. Amen? But we're proud of you, buddy. Amen. Proud of the work you do at the high school. All the, you know, you got a big basketball season coming up. When's the next games?
Tuesday.
Where? Home. What time?
5:30 and 7:30,
JV, 7 varsity. He coaches JV still,
yep.
And in assist on varsity. So if you want to come out, Fellowship Church, support Lemon Bay High School basketball, and you're doing pretty good, aren't you?
Pretty good.
Come on out this week, Tuesday. Watch some basketball at the high school. Thank you for giving today. Amen.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you. Mm. We thank you for the blessings you've given us through the church and through our families and everything, Lord. We've had heartaches, but we've had tribulations because we know you are with us at all times, Lord. We thank you for everything you do. We ask you to bless this offering, bless our pastor. Mm. Thank you for 2022 being done and over with. Now we live for today, Lord.
Amen.
2023, yes. Here we go. Thank you for everything you do. We ask you again, bless this offering, bless the giver, bless our pastor as he delivers your message. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Appreciate you, buddy boy. Love you, man. Proud of you. Love you, buddy. Thank you. Guys, again, thank you for giving, especially if you're watching online. I know you can seem disconnected, and I get that. But I appreciate you watching online, writing a note. I read them about 1 o'clock. I'm no more special than anybody else. I'm just letting you know that whatever you write, I read, and I'm encouraged by it. Thank you for giving to the Lord's work. We appreciate you. Thank you for doing that. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. And all I have needed, thy hand has provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Let's thank the Lord for Miss Karen. Everybody serving us. Amen. All right, let's get settled in. Come on. Time for the word. Amen. Y'all ready? Now, she's not leaving because she's mad. No, ain't had a chance yet. Here we go. Come on. Here we go. Let's go to the word. Like I said, I preach out of the Bible. Okay? The Bible. And I preach a certain way. I know I'm not, certain people do it different ways. I try to be evangelistic in when I'm talking. I always want to make sure that people, when they come to Fellowship Church, they can know the Lord. I don't want them to leave, well, that was a nice little Bible study. I want them to know the Lord. It's a big deal. People getting up, going to church. I remember when I first went with Mama years ago. She, you know, wanted me to go with her, and I cussed her out on the way. Unbelievable. And the Lord saved me, 3 weeks later. And so it's just a big deal coming to church. It won't get you to heaven, but it sure can get you where you can hear the gospel. And there's just something about where two or three are gathered in His name. He's in the middle. Amen. And He can touch you today. So my prayer today is that you've made it this far. Don't leave lost. Okay? If you're not a Christian, if you might say, well, I'm a good person. I go to church. But do you know Jesus Christ is your Savior? The Bible says today is the day of salvation. It just means today is a day that you need to deal with that. And go ahead and nail that. He was nailed to the cross, so you could nail that in your heart. And you can know for sure that He's your Savior and your Lord. But anyway, I have the scriptures. But what changes is life. Life changes, Like I said, I wrote this series 15 years ago. And I'll reread things and look at scriptures, look at them differently. But you know what's changed is me. 15 years. The church, when I preached this series years ago, was 5 years old in a high school. Who would have thought would have been there 7.5 more years at that high school? If you'd asked me 15 years ago, oh no, we'll be out of here in like 2 years. But we did it debt-free. It meant we had to stay steady. But who stayed steady with us? The Lord the whole way. Amen? But it's a series on living today. Living today. Today's all you have, man. We act like, we got a tomorrow. On Christmas Eve, families in our church were deeply hurt, affected, devastated by the loss of a little 3-month-old baby. And didn't know the child was sick, to our knowledge, anything like that. Lost another fella, full of life. Hadn't seen him in a while. But K.C. Clement went home to be with the Lord. But I remember when K.C. came to Christ many years ago. And he was just a tough fella. But I loved the color. I loved his attitude. You just never know what a day is going to bring. Y'all hear me or not? Say. You just don't know, man. You need to live now. Say that with me. Live what? Let's go to the word. Here we go, Raj. Today. 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 It's all you have. You don't have anything else. I'll do it next week. You don't have next week. You keep thinking like that, it's going to be 2024 and you're still going to be screwed up. You got a chance, man. Today, 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 today. I want to drive this home. It's all I have. Let's talk about it. What do you mean, Clark? Well, I'm glad you asked. Here we go. People say it all day long. They say this, I'm living a day at a time. Just a day at a time. Most people don't. Most people don't. They're not doing that. They say that. I think they're lying. Most people, every day, they get up, they do the same thing, whatever. They don't change. Same attitude, same crap. Excuse my language. Got a chance, though. Every day, same, whatever. I got tomorrow. Listen, days don't matter to most people, and time don't matter to most folk. I tell you what, it's ticking, isn't it? Yes or no? I mean, to think 15 years ago, I wrote a lot of this stuff. I mean, that's amen? Even the hurricane, I mean, it was like several months ago. Yeah, we're still cleaning up. We're still working hard. Absolutely. But time just moves, doesn't it? Say, another hurricane season will be here before you know it. I'm just saying. You better be living in the now, guys. It's all you have today. That's it. That's it. It's all I got. Let's talk about it just a little bit. Okay? That's a nice clock. Look at that, Raji. You know I don't do any of that. Y'all know I have none of these skills, right? All I do is talk for a living. I can't do any of this stuff. That's pretty, buddy. Thanks. Do it now, man. That's the title of my message today. Do it now. Do it now. Do it now. Let's roll through a lot of this, Raj. If you're always talking about tomorrow, say it with me. You'll never what? How many's like that? You've done that before. You just talked about it and there it's set. Nothing done. Okay? The one area we have the most control over in our life is what? Well, I wish the Lord would do this, and I wish she would do that, and I wish he would do whatever. Listen, the most control you have is you doing something today. You. Well, I pray about it. How about get off your rear end and do it? Today. Today's the first day of 2023. We don't have the first always on a Sunday starting a year. That's why I wanted to talk like this. Today! Today's the day to stop complaining about 2022. Yes or no, amen? Come on, move forward and do it by living today. The best chance you have is what? And if you knew my life, well, that's way back there. How about now? I know it's a little tough, guys, but that's what we need. Amen? People who never start living in the now, it seems like their problems never stop. Oh, my gosh. Always, whatever. And when you talk like that and think like that, it seems like you got more problems just keep adding up. Get something done. Do it when? Today. Absolutely. Living today means doing it now. This is an old Southern statement. Say that with me. Get her when? Say it louder. Come on. Get her today. Y'all thinking about stuff you got to do right now, ain't it? Oh, my gosh. He makes me feel bad. Good. If a little old kick in your rear end will get something done, then get it done. Get it done. Life's big, man. Life's more than just some mess in the yard. Okay, and some renovations on the house. Life's bigger than that. Life is about you and your attitude and your heart and situations and relationships. That's what we put off. We could go and we could fix something today, but it might take you humbling yourself. It might take you saying you're sorry. It might take you moving forward and trying to be a blessing, even if you don't get the sorry that you want from somebody else. You hear me or not? Am I talking to you? Living in the now. Man, you can have all the plans in the world, but they're useless. One day we go to what? They're useless unless you take action when? Today. Today. Live in the now. Accept. Oh, here's a cuss word to a lot of people. Accept what? Accept responsibility for what? Okay. Yeah, well, I'm sick. I got this problem. I got this disease. Are you still alive? Even if they ain't, but just half of what you used to be. Take that half and make it the best you can today. And be a blessing. This series actually made sense to do because I talked way back in the summer, July. Get up. Get up. About the disciples. About how we are in our life. How we just get down. And then I moved into a series, and after that was obviously, and the end of that series was, let the Holy Spirit of the living God crawl up inside of you. He wants to love through you. And if you weren't here, I'm sorry. You can go back and listen to some of these messages. But then we went into a series called Be Believable. Be Believable. You can do that today. You can start today. Stop being a hypocrite and stop being a sham. Get right with God today. You can do that. We can be believed. That's what the world wants us to be. They want somebody that's real. Then we moved in towards Christmas and we did a series called Shine Your Light. So wait a minute. Get up. Be believed. Shine your light. When? Got it or not? Let my light shine. Where? When? What? Who? How? Be believable. When? When? That's all just talk. It's bull. Unless we do it when? Today. Today. And you might say, Heaney, put no scripture up yet. Yeah, it's coming. Keep looking. Life isn't fair. That's why people don't live in the now. Life ain't fair. Well, let me tell you something. It ain't never going to be fair. Quit doing this. Stop looking for the tooth fairy. Okay? Well, when this gets right, when this happens, when this does, and I'll start. It's the start that stops most people. Okay? Life isn't going to always be fair. Okay? Yeah, but if you knew what I went through. Can we just do a real quick poll? How many been through some stuff? Can I see some hands? Okay, put you in there. It's just no excuse. No excuse. In football, we don't give a hoot about last week. If you stunk up the field last week, this is a new day and it's a new night. And go out there and beat the tar out of them. Okay? That's life. Live it, man. Don't live in the past. Take responsibility and do what? Live what? Today. Today. Quit waiting for things to be what? Well, that's the way we are, though. Mr. Right comes along. How about you work on you? You know what I'm saying? We can do that, can't we? We can work on us, and maybe that'll help in the future. Yes or no, amen. But if we're just always waiting for this, come on. Focus on what you can do when? Today. Today. Am I driving you crazy? Say it with me. Anything worth doing is worth doing when? If it's something you're thinking about that's worth something, probably worth starting it right now. Are you in denial about living in the now? After I did all that talking, are you waiting for somebody else to step up? You're waiting for somebody else to step up and start living. If they'll just pull their weight, if they would just do, and I know there's hurt and there's pain, and there's laziness and sorriness all over. I get that. But guys, if you do something, you might be in a tough marriage. How about this? How about you take the part of the marriage that you have and you try to be the best you can be and start being that today and see if that marriage might not get better. It's going to get better because you're getting better. But we're always looking over here. We need to look right here and look this way. Hello. Help me, Lord. Amen. So why not you and why not when? Today. Today. That's our talk. If you're waiting for things to be perfect before you start, you'll never make it. You'll never make it. It's funny how people win the lottery. Most of them have lost it within a year or two. They didn't know how to spend money before they got it. And now they got it. About a year passes, they don't got it. Years ago, a guy in Englewood won the lottery in Englewood, Florida. I mean, he won the big one. Built a big house out there on Lemon Bay before you get to the Manasota Beach Bridge. You'd have to be in the water to see it. Big old house. He lost that house and he lost everything. If you think money's going to fix you, here's the best thing to fix you. You start living for Jesus Christ today. And his word, and see if things don't get better. Live for him. Live by his principles, not your way, getting it all just perfect. You know, it's crazy. If God can take a guy like me, a hellraiser from Rockingham, he can take anybody in this room and do something with them. And he's a faithful God. Amen? He's incredible. Say that out loud. It's really important. It's a quote that I love. Say it out loud. It's the start that stops most people. A lot of people will start diet plans right now. And I thought about it yesterday as I shoved everything in my mouth I possibly could. Tomorrow, I mean, how many did that? You were like me. I mean, you ate that right down to the last wire. And here's my daughter, like 11:30 last night. She's coming in there, Danny, wanting to get some ice cream. I'm like, hey, you don't need no ice cream. You get on out of here. After I'd eaten like a pig, like about 2 minutes before she walked in. I'm terrible. But it's a start that stops most people. That's why people make resolutions around January, because January 1st, because it's just something we struggle with. We struggle with starting. But when you have something like a new year, it sort of helps people in a way. But only 7% of those people that resolve to do something get it done. Only 7%. You know what I mean? And a lot of it is tied to the new year. A lot of people do have some success right there, but it's still a small number. Guys, the best way is you take personal responsibility for your life. And you say, today matters. What I'm doing today matters. I matter. Say that with me. I have value. And what I'm doing matters today. Okay, living in the now. You can start from Fellowship Church in Englewood, Florida. And you get anywhere you want to in the world. I want you to think about that. You can start right here at this campus. You can make a decision today. You can make a decision right here today. And you can go anywhere in the world. You change your world if you start living day by day, day by day. I'm going to live in the now. I'm going to squeeze it. I'm going to squeeze my day. I'm going to take personal responsibility for my day. I'm not going to think about tomorrow. Now, I understand planning a little bit, but we plan so much, we miss today. And most people can't live in today and the now because they can't get past their past. Their past has got them, man, and they can't live in the now. Y'all hearing me? Well, so it's a start that stops most people. Rod, you're doing good, buddy. I appreciate you. Let's go with it. See what we can find. So we're in the series, Do It. The message today, Do It Now. But let's talk about it from the scriptures. So often, worry, and this is my message. You might have other problems, but I'm just talking from experience. Worrying about mess keeps us from living today and getting anything of value accomplished. Worrying is the biggest problem that we have in living today. You hear me or not? Say. How many are like me? You can get a negative thought. I'm talking about something bad. I mean, maybe something's happened to you, or a struggle you're going through. How many can let that negative thought get up there? And it can take you down. I mean, it can take you down for hours. Anybody else like me like that? I'm that way. I mean, I can let that thing get up there and fester. How many are like that? You let something fester. And you want to fix it, or you want this, or you're expecting somebody else to act or respond a certain way, and it's not happening, so it just takes you down deeper. Is that making any sense? Okay, guys, I'm telling you, worrying, fretting. How about this word? What's that next one? Stressing. What does that do? Well, I can worry, I can fret, I can stress. Here's what it does. It kills productivity. That's like putting a monkey on your back, about 9 monkeys. And you're trying to get something done, but that worry, that fretting, that stressing is killing your productivity. And then you might say, well, okay, let's talk about it. And destroys relationships. Who wants to live with a worrier, a stressor, and a fretter? Say, oh, they're beautiful. No, they ain't. And that's not God's plan. He called us the light of the world, not the pain in the rear. Yes or no, amen? We're the light of the world. You're the salt of the earth. But what good is it if it's lost its savor? And that's what happens when we worry, when we stress, when we fret. We lose our energy, our strength, our effectiveness. Jesus knows what he's talking about. Listen to him. You'd be wise to read Matthew 6. Just park it there and just spend a lot of time over there. You can start chapter 5 and go on back to chapter 7. Change your life. So, how can I live in the now? How can I live today? Say that with me. Stop what? And start what? Hang in here. Stop worrying and start realizing. Jesus said, I say unto you, take no thought for your life. What I'm going to do here or there. What you going to eat. What you going to drink. I want you to think about it. That's what consumes most of our life. What we eat and what we're going to wear for our body. What you going to put on. Jesus says, is not your life more than meat? Is your body not more than the clothes you're wearing? Okay? Listen, stop worrying about those things. Stop fretting about your life so much. God feeds birds. Keep going. Behold, he says, the fowls of the air. How many love bird watching? You like that? I love that. It can just get me happy. See a little bird. Or a big bird, like an eagle the other day, big one. Then I saw this little bird chasing a big eagle. Get out of here, he said. The eagle left. You know? But listen, birds don't stress out. Look what the Bible, Jesus says, behold the fowls of the air. They don't sow. They don't plant a garden. They don't reap. No. They don't gather into barns, but your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much better than birds? Say. Guys, it's living today is part of changing your thinking. And guys, don't think I'm trying to talk down to you. This is the pot calling the kettle black, okay? I've struggled, and I still struggle with it. But this is true, man. This is great stuff. Stop worrying and start realizing, man, I'm better than birds. God takes care of me. Amen. And worrying doesn't what? How many by worrying yourself to death, it really helped you? How many you worried yourself what? Sick. How many of you did that? You worried yourself sick. How many of you worried and stressed out it caused you major health problems? Can I see some hands? Hands in the room today. Jesus is trying to say, live today. Live today. Stop worrying. Which of you by taking thought can add one cubit to his stature? You look in the mirror and go, I don't like me. I'm too short. You think that's going to fix it? Or you look in the mirror and, you know, like me, man, I wish I had more hair. You think that's going to work? There's certain things we can change. I get that, guys. But, man, it sure would help you if you would have just, what happens? This kills praise. It kills thankfulness to the Lord. Worrying is of the devil. You hear me, yes or no? Because it just, all of a sudden, instead of focusing on the good and on him, we start focusing on the bad and the negative. Is that true or false? Of course it's true. Stop worrying and start having what? Stop worrying. Start having faith. There's an option here. Okay? Why take you thought for your raiment, your clothes? All right? Worried about your wardrobe? I don't have anything to wear. How many, be honest, you didn't go out one night because you had nothing to wear? But if the truth be known, you had something to wear, didn't you? Yes or no? It just wasn't what you thought. Wasn't thought like it looked good enough or maybe what would be acceptable. How about you accept yourself and know that God loves you? Never has been about your clothes. He loves you. This helps, man. You're taking thought for your raiment. Just walk outside, look at the flowers. Look at the lily of the field. They grow. They're not wringing their hands. They're just looking pretty. That's what God wants for you. I say unto you that even Solomon, all his glory, was not arrayed like one of these lilies of the field. See, God looks at you and he sees awesome. He sees somebody I love so much that I'll give my son for. That I love so much that I'll forgive all the bad, nasty things they've ever done. I love them. If they'll put their faith in me, I'll save them. That's how valuable you are. You hear me or not? Come on, good stuff. Jesus said, if God so clothed the grass of the field, which today is and tomorrow is burned up and gone, shall he not much more clothe? You say it out loud. Oh, ye of little. So we need to stop worrying. Worrying kills productivity. Stressing kills productivity. It kills our day. It kills our relationships. How many ever lost a job because you were just shot? You were just worried so much, it killed you at your job. Anybody want to raise a hand and say that out loud? Lost my job. Lost my job. It's a mess, guys. And this can help. Faith. Know you matter to me, God says. You're fine. A lot of people don't come to church because they feel like they don't have anything to wear, especially an older crowd. Even I see it. I had some guy, had a football player the other day, came right here up to me the other day at his Christmas Eve service. He's 17 years old. He doesn't have a home. He lives from home to home to home. He said, I just loved on him. I'm so glad to see him. I'm glad you're here, man. You know what he said? Next time, I'll dress better. I never saw his clothes. I saw his smile. I saw his eyes beaming. I saw his effort that he made to come here. It's all bull. You hear me? And God says, you need to get a handle on this. Start trusting me. Okay, I want you to live your life every day. Stop worrying and stop stressing. Faith comes by what? How can I have faith, Pastor? How can I have faith? By hearing what? The Word of God. If you're wanting one more little self-help thing, and sometimes that works, it does. But guys, there's nothing like knowing you're fearfully and wonderfully made, knowing that I'm saved, Jesus Christ gave his life for me, that he loves me, and then hearing his word and start putting it into your life, like it's doing for some of you right now. I can tell right now. Some of the word has already started to get in you this morning. And that's good stuff, man. That's beautiful. Faith is a substance of things what? It's the evidence of things not seen. Listen, you put your trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Ronnie, this morning you quoted that. Lean not unto your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he'll do what? He'll direct your path. He'll take care of you today. Without faith, it's impossible to please him. For he that comes to God must believe that he is. And he's a rewarder of those that diligently seek him. God will bless you if you live today. Stop worrying, stressing, fretting. Put your faith in him. Hide God's word in your heart. I can't read the Bible. See, there you go again. Excuse maker. Take responsibility for your life being sorry. God loves you. You can have a great life. You can have a future. And it certainly can be better than what it is right now. I'll tell you that right now. Yes or no, amen. Not saying you don't have hard times. I'm not saying some of you aren't struggling with deep things. I understand that. But guys, what am I supposed to do? Pat you on the head and say, okay, just wander off into the wild blue or whatever. I want to try to lift you up a little bit. I have to shake you a little. Okay? Stop worrying and start what? Okay, so realize and then have faith. And now worship. Therefore, take no thought saying, what shall we eat or what shall we drink or wherewithal shall we be clothed? After all these things to the Gentiles, or people don't even know the Lord. They seek the same things, guys. They're that way. They're screwed up. They're stressed out. But you're a believer in Christ and you're letting that happen? Your Heavenly Father knows you have need of all these things. Say this incredible verse. You ought to memorize it. Say it out loud. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness and all these things shall be added unto you. How many have seen that verse come true in your life? Isn't that beautiful? Isn't that beautiful? God is good, man. Evening and morning and at noon will I pray and cry aloud, and he shall hear my voice. Do it today. I'll pray tomorrow. How about today? Unto thee, O Lord, do I lift up my soul. O my God, I trust in you. Let me not be ashamed. Let not my enemies triumph over me. One of my favorite scriptures. Yea, let none that wait on thee be ashamed. Let them be ashamed which transgress without cause. Show me your ways, O Lord. Teach me your paths. Lead me into truth. Teach me, for you're my God, you're the God of my salvation. On thee, though I wait all day long. Worship him. Worship him today. You hear me or not? Stop worrying and start what? Living today. Take therefore no thought for tomorrow. For tomorrow is going to take thought for the things of itself. I always love Jesus saying this, that last part. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof. We got communion, we got to quit. I like that scripture. I love it. Back it up, buddy. We're going to pop it right there. We'll just stay right there if you don't mind. Take no thought, Jesus says, for tomorrow. Isn't that what I've been saying? Yes or no? Driving you up the wall, ain't I? Tomorrow's going to take thought of the things of itself. If you get a tomorrow, there'll be plenty of garbage and mess to deal with tomorrow. Okay? How about today? How about today? Yeah, I like the scripture because he says, sufficient unto the day is the what? Evil thereof. What does that mean to Gary? Here's what that means. Gary, instead of you worrying about the future or what you got to face in 2 weeks or 3 weeks, if you really want to think about it, there's some mess right now you can deal with. There's some crap, there's that word again, that you can tackle right now, today. You don't need to wait for tomorrow to have some stuff to deal with. Amen? Am I losing you? I know what I'm talking about. I don't know if I'm communicating it properly. Live now. Deal with stuff now. You can't fix it all, but you can fix some of it. Do it. Do it. Know that God's with you. You're better than a bird. You're more intricate than any lily ever. God loves you, gave his son for you. And you got people like my mama and people you know that's in heaven cheering you on. They're cheering you on. Stop living your life in the dumps and negative and down and I can't make it. Yes, you can. Because I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. There's all kinds of scripture, man. You can do this. Brand new year, brand new start, brand new day. Yeah, but you don't understand. Come on, I want to pop you upside the head. Did y'all hear the message? Please tell them to be quiet. So, today is the day to what? What? You mean I could put my faith in Christ today and I'd never have to worry about going to hell never again? You won't have to ever again. Today's the day to get what? You're away from him. You could come right now. Today's the day to get right with who? You can try. You can try, right? Why not try? Today's the day to do what? Family. Today is the day to do what? Instead of hold it over the head till you die one day. Why don't you enjoy the big smile on their face? Because you live in the now and you're blessing people today with what you have. Today is the day to what? I can do this. Today is the day to do what? You want to jump out of an airplane? You use a parachute, but do it. I did it years ago. Hey, do something cool. Do something you've been wanting to do. If it's right with the Lord, doesn't offend him, do it. Let's thank the Lord for his word. We're done. Amen. Boom! Amen. Come on. Get on up. I appreciate you. Now listen. Listen. Hang on. Hang on. Heads bowed, please. You're in my day, so watch it. Now listen, you're at a church that wants people to go to heaven. God's not willing that any should perish, but that all come to repentance. God wants men, women, boys, and girls everywhere to be saved. He died for all of them. And that means you. The Bible says if you'll confess with your mouth Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, you shall be saved. Would you do that today? Would you stop saying, well, I go to church, or I did this, or I did that? Have you done this? Believe on the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Bible says, and thou shalt be saved. Can I lead you in a prayer right now where you do that today? Today. Stop making up excuses. I go to church. I do this. I watch preachers on TV. It sounds really silly when you compare it to the death of Jesus Christ on the cross and his resurrection. Would you believe in him today and put your faith in him today? Can I lead you in a prayer? Will you humble yourself right now? Let's pray together. Lord Jesus, I know I am a sinner. I've been a sinner my whole life. I'm a sinner today. And I ask for your forgiveness, Lord. And Jesus, I want you to know that today, right now, I put my faith in you, Jesus. I don't understand it all. You know I don't. But Jesus, best I know how, I'm putting my faith, my belief, my trust, not in myself or a church or a preacher. No, I'm putting my faith in you, Jesus Christ. I believe you did die on the cross. I believe you did raise from the dead. And I believe you love me. Come into my life and live today. Live today through me. And Lord, if you give me a tomorrow, oh, I'll live for you tomorrow. But today is the day, Lord. I put my faith in you in Jesus' name. Amen. How many with heads bowed would raise a hand right before we have communion? How many would say, Pastor Gary, today is the day I got saved. I put my faith in Christ. I did that today. Can I see your hand? I did that. I did that today, Pastor Gary. Several of your hands. I did that today. God bless you today. Amen. Lord, help us with the message. Help us as we go out here and have communion. What a beautiful thing. First day of the year. A good message that can go along with helping us really have an incredible start to a brand new year. But Lord, we know a year is just a day. It's just a day and then another day. So Lord, help us live this day. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Amen. Come on, let's go. We're doing it. Come on, let's go have communion. If you've not done this with us before, it goes pretty quick. Come on. Come on. Right outside. You'll think you're in the snow out here in the fog.